Parents do their best to protect their family from dangers they can see. Sometimes there are dangers they cannot see. Lead is a metal that has been used to make many different things which are often found in the home. Let us explore some areas in the home where lead can be found. Kids can be exposed to lead by things they put in their mouth or eat. It can also be in dust and inhaled. Our bodies do not need lead. When lead gets in our bodies, it can move to the blood, brain, bones, and other organs. Even when the source of lead is removed, it can stay in the body for years. Children younger than 6 have more problems when they are exposed to lead because their brains are still developing. With low lead levels in the blood, you may not notice any symptoms in your child. But lead can affect your child's ability to learn, focus, and make decisions. At higher lead levels, you can have behavioral changes and damage organs in the body, sometimes needing medicine or a trip to the hospital. There are things you can do to decrease lead exposure at home. Good hygiene can keep lead from mixing in with your food. Have everyone wash hands before meals and snacks. Do not let your kids eat food off the floor. Have them eat meals and snacks at the table. Providing your child with key nutrients like iron, calcium, and vitamin C can decrease how much lead gets into your child and keeps his or her body and brain healthy and strong. Children with a low iron level in their blood can feel tired and cold, find it hard to think or concentrate, and can easily get sick. You can find iron in spinach, chicken, beef, pork, fish, and beans. Vitamin C is important because it helps your body use iron better. Foods rich in vitamin C like oranges, tomatoes, berries, and broccoli are really good foods. Calcium is important for healthy bones. The right amount of milk is 3 glasses a day. Too much milk can decrease how much iron your body can absorb. Sources of calcium include milk, yogurt, cheese, eggs, figs, leafy greens, and sardines. Getting your child screened for lead is very important, especially if they are younger than 6. Identifying the problem early can help your doctor and the school work with your child and your child's development. Talk to your child's doctor to see if a lead level has been checked or if a test is needed.